This is Esther.
And this is Maria.
And together we are
the Concert Playing!
In concert playing, every musician is equally important. It doesn't matter how many players there are, each and every one of them are equally responsible and significant for an impeccable and a perfect final result.
However, we have to admit that each role in concert playing has its own characteristics. It feels very different to play the bass, the top line, or a middle line, and you have to adjust to the specialities of these lines to have the best results.
Today, we would like to give you 10 tips for those of you who are in charge of the top line. And playing the upper line in ensemble playing very often also means that you play on a very small recorder, maybe a descant or soprano, maybe a sopranino, maybe even sometimes a garg line.
Our tips will help you to become a better top line player, but also a better player of the smallest members of our big recorder family.
You may have encountered people who think that small recorders always sound shrill and unpleasant. And this social pressure that's created by society on players of the soprano recorder means that a lot of us tend to play this instrument as soft as possible and a little bit scared.
However, the reason why high instruments exist is because they can sound brilliant like trumpets, sweet like birds, and light and agile like butterflies. Finding all these colors is a much nicer inspiration than being afraid of our own sound. So, don't be shy, but shine!
Play a series of three long notes, the high E, high G, and the middle C. And when you do that, listen very well and feel also the vibration of the sound under your fingers and find the perfect sound for each of those tones. Feel how you are filling the room with your beautiful, shiny sound.
Once you have found this beautiful vibrating sound, turn these three long notes into a little bird song by adding ornaments and changing your articulation, like this.
Last step of this exercise is to have, if you are on your own, a short improvisation, or if you are with colleagues, you can have a dialogue in which you are going to use very short bird calls. You send out a bird call and you wait for an answer to come.
A good sound on a small recorder, as described in the previous tip, may have various colors. It may be connected or detached, it may be playful or singing, but you never want to appear heavy or forced.
To sound light as a feather on the smaller instruments, we give you three tips. Number one, produce a thin and fast stream of air, as we have discussed in some of our previous episodes.
Articulate very precisely with small movements of the tip of your tongue behind your teeth.
Number three, be aware that excessive tone shaping is very exposed on these instruments because they are very sensitive to pressure changes in your airstream. There is a well-known analogy of a music ensemble with the four elements. Earth is the base, which is the fundament of everything. On top of that, we have water and fire, the middle lines that flow and take care of movement in the music. And then on top of that, we have the lightest of the four elements, the air, that is the top line.
If you translate this analogy into ensemble sound, the lower voices should sound fuller and act as a reference for the higher voices. If the lower voices have a good sound and a good mixture, it will be much easier for the higher ones to naturally find their sound on top of them and mix into these lower and buzzing sounds of the basses. Plus, it's much easier to tune like this.
The top line player should ideally feel that they can naturally rest on the sound of the lower voices. And this is also why, when we are doing tuning exercises or when we want to build up a piece, starting with only a few voices and then adding the rest, we usually do so from bottom to top, from earth to air.
Top-line players feel responsible to conduct the ensemble by giving entrances, showing the character of the piece, and sometimes also give timings when that's necessary in the music.
This comes with a slight risk of overconducting. When you want to show every little moment and every little intention, it may be that the top-line player ends up feeling not so free. So our suggestion would be, let go, divide the leadership of all these different interesting moments among the different lines, and do it more by listening and less by looking.
Since higher voices and higher instruments are naturally much more exposed, it's good to know some tricks to make your sound lighter. Any tricks to make your sound more delicate without sounding too careful may be very effective.
Spend some time checking out some alternative fingerings and ways in which you may manipulate the sound, especially in the higher register, to make it as mild as possible.
For example, if you like to have lighter, higher notes, you can roll your index finger a bit down so that the hole opens a little bit on the top, and the pitch will be a little bit higher, so therefore you need to blow a bit softer and the sound becomes much more thin and also more delicate.
Practice this trick with long notes at first to get really comfortable with it, keep the pitch, and then when you are a master of this technique, you can even apply it to whole passages in the high register to lighten your sound. And there are many other tricks waiting to be discovered.
The smaller the instrument is that we play and the faster the music is that we play, the cooler we need to be. Because keeping cool means that we stay in control, and it also means avoiding tension, physical or mental. So no panic, no rushing, just the necessary enjoyment.
When you need to play difficult passages on small recorders, a few bars before the tricky stuff is coming, relax and make your finger movements small but active. Be aware of the risk of over-enthusiastic playing, which can lead into too many accents and bad coordinations with the rest of the ensemble.
Small recorders don't need as much air as the bigger ones, and this has two consequences. One, in most music you don't need to fill yourself completely up to make the end of the phrase. Still, always keep the length of the phrase inside and only take the air you need for it in a relaxed way.
Second consequence is, you can probably make much longer phrases on a small instrument than you can on a bigger one. But to make those long phrases, you also need stamina, because it's a long time without taking any breath. So, for example, in Renaissance polyphony, you will be able to play the same length of a phrase that a singer would be able to sing. And to do that, you need to make sure you train your breathing support enough so that you can have the tension it takes to make it till the end, but at the same time you still sound and feel relaxed as you want the music to flow.
Small recorders are easy to balance on your lip and your thumb. This will give the other fingers the freedom to easily move, and also it will improve your sound. So hold your instrument high enough to experience this kind of freedom.
Small recorders speak very quickly, they react immediately to your input, and larger recorders, they are a little bit slower, especially the bigger ones that have a crook, because the air takes a long time to get in there. So when we are playing top line, we need to be aware of what is the largest instrument in the ensemble, how much time do they need to think ahead to be as fast as we are. And in that sense, it's good to have some empathy and to give enough time when we are taking breaths, giving cues, so that we can all really start spot on together.
When you play the top line on smaller instruments, you probably have more than one choice. Try all different options. The difference in the mix between instruments, even when they're from the same brand, might be shocking.
These are the smallest recorders that we own. We have soprano in C, we have, of course, sopraninos in F, and we also have garclines. The garcline is one whole octave higher than the soprano, so they are also tuned in C. There was a recorder maker in the Netherlands whose name was Frans Twaalfhoven, who invented an even smaller size of recorder than the garcline, which has still all the finger holes in it, because there are smaller pipes that sound very high, but not a full recorder. This tiny recorder was called the piccolino, and it's tuned in F, a whole octave above the sopranino, so it is exactly half the size. Now, unfortunately, we don't have one of those, but you can imagine how much of a challenge it is to play on such a small instrument where your fingers are one on top of the other and the finger holes are displaced to the side. Very exciting.
Whee! Funny enough, the son of Frans Twaalfhoven, Merlijn Twaalfhoven, who is a composer, wrote a piece for us that is the highest we have ever played. It is for 13 small recorders, all sopranos, sopraninos and garclines, and organ. And this piece was written for the Royal with Music. Have a lovely week and see you next Monday! Bye-bye!